here's the simplest way for me to describe Killzone Liberation for the PlayStation Portable. One, it's a remake of the first Killzone, pretty much. That's what it feels like, with almost no focus on the story, made into a third-person isometric shooter. And two, it's a blast to play. What I mean by the remake is that none of the environments in this game are new. The dust-filled war grounds, the big steel infrastructure, the swampy jungles, the snowy space station, it's all recycled from the first Killzone. But that said, it really isn't something to complain about, because the game itself is, in my opinion, extremely fun. I haven't played too many shooters on the PSP for the obvious reason that the thing only has one analog stick thingy-ma-zingy, but I have to hand it to Guerrilla Games for nailing how shooters should be made on the PSP. All the mechanics work in this game are that are work at this game are extremely fluid. To crouch, you just hold on to the right shoulder button, and it works great as a cover mechanic. While crouching, if you fire weapons by pressing square, the character automatically stands up out of the cover and fires and will duck back into cover when you let go of the fire button. The character automatically locks onto a given target, so there is no need for a lock-on button. Pressing circle to target the destination of the grenade works really well as well, and this also locks onto enemy in range automatically. Simply put, the controls work quite brilliantly, and the mechanics are just fluid and smooth, making the gameplay experience extremely engaging and a blast to play. The game is also very challenging. Unless you're playing on easy difficulty, any single enemy can kill you if you're not quick enough to respond. Their bullets will do a lot of damage, and strafing and rolling around and making sure to kill them out of their range are all crucial strategies. Switching weapons via weapon storage boxes and using the right kind of weapons are important, and your reflex skills actually do kind of matter in this game, which I thought was unusual for an isometric shooter. I do have to complain that some enemy types just take way too many bullets to kill, but it's hard to complain about this when the enemy I felt was designed just perfectly. They're not too smart, which would make the game unfairly hard, but they're not necessarily dumb either. They take cover and they rush you. For a handheld shooter, what more could you ask for? The thing that I absolutely hate about the game, though, was the sniper rifle. It acts like every other weapon, except that it can just shoot further. You can't see through the scope to make the perfect kills, and it doesn't even do that much damage. It takes 3 sniper bullets to kill a regular Hellgas grunt, and with each sniper bullet, it's like... And without the ability to actually aim what you're shooting, it's a useless weapon. And I just didn't like it. What's the point of having a sniper rifle if you can't aim far away with it? But that said, the game's a blast. Some levels are just a blast to breeze through, like when you get control of a tank, or when you're running away from incoming Helgen forces while searching for a downed ally pilot. There are only 2 boss battles in the game, but the last boss battle you have, I thought was just really awesome. It's an epic one-on-one duel requiring cover, lots of rolling, he fires a barrage of grenades at you, and just constant shooting. Pretty kick-ass if you ask me. To top it all off, the game has a pretty good replay value. There are mini-games to play to earn points. When you earn a lot of points, you can unlock different abilities, like being able to carry more ammo, or having more health when you start out a mission. These mini-games are actually really fun too, ranging from target practice to luring spider mines to cages, and even just surviving an incoming enemy onslaught, killing as many Hellgas as you possibly could. Every campaign level has a certain amount of money to collect, and the more you collect, the more likely you'll be able to unlock different starting weapons. Finally, there's an ad hoc multiplayer feature that sounds pretty fun on paper. I haven't tried it because I really don't have many friends to play PSP with, but it does sound really great. Overall, I really enjoyed this game. It doesn't really provide much of a backstory to the Killzone universe, but I wasn't expecting that. I was just expecting to have a good fun time, and that's what I got. And the great thing about it is that the game has great pacing. After I beat it, I felt like it was only an 8-hour long game, but then I looked at my playtime, which is recorded. The game told me I spent 20 hours and 34 minutes on it. Wow, I guess time just flew when I was having so much fun with the game.